You look at the Magic, in position to close it out tonight, sweep the series, and celebrate.
But these home fans are hoping it won't be tonight. If nothing else, get one win, extend the series, and send it back on the road.
A look at the opening lineup for the Orlando Magic. Mo Bamba out there with Wendell Carter. Then it's Suggs. Then there's Wagner. And it's Turner in at the point guard position. And for New Orleans, Ingram at the three, Zion at the four. Then there's Jonas Valanciunas. Then there's C.J. McCollum. And it's Jones in at the two. And the Magic start out with the ball. Williamson against Turner. And then Turner with the dunk.
Woo! When you finish like that, you deserve to brag.
Impressive, no question.
How about that from your point guard, gentlemen? Playing big at the rim, okay?
Shots good.
Well, the touch and the focus. What a pretty move in the lane.
Here's Turner. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line. The first. Pencil Turner nails them both.
An efficient night from the line. This is a guy who puts in the work and it pays dividends.
Left side Jones. And that one's good. Now here's Turner. Out to the right wing. About a minute played here so far in the first. Oh, deflected. McCollum with a steal. Down low. Here's Jones. Boom! He jams it straight down.
You'd love to see Zion develop his passing game even more. But credit to him for spotting the wide open man.
Here's Turner. And then Turner with the dunk.
Wow. I'll tell you, such an advantage having a playmaker who can get up to the rim and finish.
Now that is what every team wants.
I love it. Fearless, aggressive, leaving no doubt whatsoever.
And the Pelicans with possession here, following the bucket by the Magic. The outside Ingram. Just five on the clock. Three-pointer. Long target from range.
4-for-4 to get things started. Must have been a good shoot around this morning.
Here's Turner. Soft touch off the glass. Turner's got 8.
That's a great beginning. 3-for-3 from the floor.
The Pelicans have gone 4-for-4 from the floor. Perfect start. Pass to Ingram. And the basket is good. Ingram's got his second bucket of the game.
A long way. Ingram has the ability to score down low. Just knocking down perimeter shots.
Well, hit a man in stride. That is a textbook delivery.
New Orleans in the lead. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. And he's going down.
See how in sync they were there.
That's what it takes to pull that off. Pass to Bamba from 13. And another basket for Orlando.
This guy has got such a good feel in the mid-range game. Mo Bamba's size, almost impossible to block that shot.
McCollum against Turner. McCollum drives in. Oh, and makes it with a kiss. McCollum's got his second basket of the night.
I love this approach. Getting him involved early is already paying off.
They know that if this guy goes off, their chances of winning rise exponentially.
And the Pelicans with possession here. For New Orleans, they've gone a perfect 7-for-7. Pass to Williamson. Williamson is double. And a bit of a jump ball. And the officials say outside, off the mark.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
To the middle. His turn. And, yep, that's going to be a flagrant one. Unnecessary contact.
He might be lucky just to get a flagrant one there. Lots of contact on that play, and the officials could have gone with a more severe call.
Well, he better be on his best behavior from this point forward. One more flagrant of any kind, and he's out of this game. Ansel Turner nails them both. Both teams will make substitutions. We've got 1:13 left in the first. Down low. Lopez passes to Turner. And the bucket counts. And he is on his way to the line. They're trying to make it a three-point play. Calls for Turner. New Orleans has gone 1 for 2 from beyond the arc in this first quarter. 58 seconds left to the first quarter of the game. Pass to Kuzma. 6 on the shot clock. Oh, and Turner with a block. To the paint. There's the steal. Now here's Hayes. Kuzma outside. Back to Hayes. That one falls. He's now 1 for 3.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations. Getting good looks inside throughout the half.
Here's Turner. And Turner with the dunk.
Now that's how you capitalize on a screen.
Yeah, good positioning too. Gave him a clear path to the hoop.
Where was the defense? No fighting through the pick. No rotation. My goodness.
There's McCollum with the three. No good there. Well, it's been a high-scoring, competitive game through the first quarter of play. Magic out in front, up 2. Don't go away. We'll be back momentarily. And we welcome you back to Game 4, folks. Thanks for joining us. All right, guys, what do you think about the Magic here in this one?
Well, their offense is clicking so far, capturing the momentum here early on.
Boy, it's been a really pretty thing to watch, executing their game plan to perfection.
Murphy's shot is good. And here are the Magic now. And for Orlando, they've got Anthony. He's out there with Jonathan Isaac. And it's Turner in at the point.
His arrow's been trending up as of late, and he's been magnificent tonight.
The Pelicans trail.
Thanks. The great one in the last game against the Pelicans really lit up the floor. He ended up with 37 points and shot the ball extremely well from both the field and the line. He had his handprint all over that game. Put up some big numbers. Guys, back to you.
Yeah, he was unstoppable during certain stretches. It'd be great to see him top that performance tonight.
Well, his team needs him to contribute. When he's on his A game, he just makes play after play.
Well, when you're coming off a game like he had, you know the difference tonight. They're going to load up against him. They're going to try to take him out of his rhythm early. Well, defensively, to me, you've got to do a better job communicating once the screen comes.
His turn. Oh, he can't miss. 8 for 8 after that shot.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Anthony against McCollum. Pass to Hayes.
Gets it down. Showing some power. Oh, save that for the dunk contest. That flush was so extra.
Whether or not this game is close, he's the same guy. Focused on finishing firm at the rim. Just an awesome display of athleticism on our AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Here's Anthony. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. And the shot's good. And the Magic lead by 2.
A massive reason they're winning. This guy hasn't missed a shot, not one.
And the Pelicans call time here. big group substitution here for... And so it's the Orlando Magic, ending the quarter up 10. Their key to consistency has been their dominance in the paint. They've been the more physical team. And the energy is palpable in this arena. Welcome back to the NBA Finals on 2K Sports. Well, Pelicans shooting is around 55% so far. It's an all Duke forward pair. Ingram the three, then there's CJ McCollum, then there's Jonas Valanciunas, and it's Jones in at the shooting guard. That's the Pelicans five. Orlando leading. Here's Turner. Wow! Now 10 for 10 after that one. He's on fire.
And the defense has no one to blame but themselves. I mean, they just let him get right to the rim.
To me, this has simply stated been a complete lack of defensive attention and focus all night long.
From the strike. And there's McCollum on the assist by Valanciunas. Valanciunas has got his third assist of the night. Up top Turner. And then Turner with the dunk.
Oh, excellent way to pad the lead.
Yeah, especially when it's your one throwing it down like that.
That's got to be a little bit deflating to the defense, guys. Getting kicked when you're down. My goodness.
Here's the floater. Out to McCollum. Beyond the arc. It's rebounded by Wagner. Turner attacking. And denied. He sends it right off the glass. Oh, there's the alley. And Williamson throws it down.
An excellent job of reading the defense. As Ingram's court vision continues to improve, so will his playmaking.
Turner. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up. It'll be on Zion Williamson. And he knocks down the first one.
Two shots.
And so Turner nails them both. The Pelicans have gone 3 of 5 from the field in this third quarter. Here's McCollum. Oh, it's blocked by Bamba.
I'll tell you, the kind of lockdown defender Mobamba can be. Send it back in there.
And we're just about 2 minutes into the final half of play now. Turner against McCollum. Pass to Bamba. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans.
Did you guys feel that when Zion slams it, the floor shakes?
Turner attacking. And then Turner with the dunk.
And he just driving the stake in him there.
He's a guy who just never lets up.
Well, you love that he wants to wear out the defense. What a catalyst for his team.
An unpredictable defensive assignment in the half court. McCollum can score from pretty much anywhere.
Orlando calls timeout.
And something fans don't always get to see, some of the closely guarded secrets that happen in that huddle.
It's tough to hide your communications. Teams go to great lengths to try to do it, but sometimes to no avail.
Hayes is checked in for the Pelicans. Kuzma comes in for Williamson.
Attacking the rim with power.
Tremendous finish. New Orleans is going 1-for-2 from outside the arc in this third quarter.
And just wasn't able to set up in time.
The Pelicans making a switch here. To the wing, right side. Hayes, the pass to McCollum. 5 to shoot. This one for 3. And another 3 for New Orleans.
Backing up that last 3 with another 3. The defense has to stop giving them so many clean looks.
Inside. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
Assertive move. You can tell the game's heating up a bit.
Get going. Pass to Hernan Gomez. Now McCollum. Here he goes. Ooh, nice concentration to hit the bucket layup. McCollum's got 13 points here in the second half alone. The Magic have got 5 of 7 attempts in the third quarter. Isaac outside. Now Anthony. Inside. Here's Turner. No good with a layup.
The battle of the boards has been something to watch.
Kuzma for 3. That's in. Coming off an assist from McCollum. McCollum's got 5 assists tonight.
And what's working here? Each guy is willing to make the next pass.
Here's Turner. Got a piece of it. Now McCollum. 19 points in the game. For the lead. And it's good on the lay-in. McCollum's got 21.
Yeah, he's been having his way this quarter. Attacking the basket and protecting their lead.
Lopez finds Turner. There's 14 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. And they pick up 2.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
I think that's the one thing every player is searching for. Consistency. They're giving this guy a chance to carry the offense once again.
Okay. It's going to be a goaltending call here, so they will count the bucket.
I mean, he has the right idea, but his timing was just a little off, and it resulted in a goaltending.
C.J. McCollum has been leading the charge for the New Orleans Pelicans. Continue to rack up points in that quarter. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Talk about painting a magnificent picture with that, Don. Just a great decision and a perfect delivery.
We call that putting it right in the pocket, and he knew what to do with it once it was there.
And with these teams locked in a very close contest, this fourth quarter promises to be a good one. Fourth quarter, on the court for the Magic. They've got Jonathan Isaac. Markelle Fultz is out there with Mo Wagner. And it's Bol in a performance position. McCollum pass to Valanciunas. Here's Murphy. Back to Valanciunas. 2 points. And the Pelicans lead by 4. Checked in for Wagner. Carter comes in for Bol, and Wagner subbed in for Isaac.
They're doing some good work at the line this half.
Pass to Williamson. Up and over Carter. Williamson, no good. And the Magic shooting a sensational 78% from the field in this game. To the paint. And stolen by Williamson. Here's Ingram. Into the lane. And a slam dunk by Ingram.
Moving so well at 6'8". Ingram will be a lot to handle if this push down the drive.
Back to Turner. Played it in with a nice touch. at 39.
This is when your interior D has to be on high alert.
For New Orleans, they've gone 2 of 3 to open the fourth quarter. Pass to Ingram. That's good. And it's McCollum with the assist. McCollum's got 6 assists here tonight.
That's 10 straight points they've given up.
Turner's got 41.
Zero rim protection. Unforgivable in a tight ball game like this.
You know, we talk about execution offensively coming down the stretch. To me, it's as important defensively, and they didn't.
And Williamson throws it down.
The great read between those two guys. The defense didn't stand a chance, DA.
These two teammates right here, Grant, they are connected.
And this is just typical of him. Always making an impact at crucial moments in the game.
This is a player who understands when the game is hanging in the balance. He knows it's winning time.
McCollum against Turner. They get the rebound. Now in Junis. The layup off target.
Boy, in that close, he's almost automatic. Boy, that's pretty good defense. Wow.
And it's Bamba finishing strong.
Seven-footer Mobamba away from the cup. What an easy finish.
.156 left to the fourth quarter. Suggs is checking for Orlando. There's 1:54 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Williamson misses. For Orlando, they've got all 4 shots to go on this final quarter. McCollum against Turner to take the lead. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot 2. He hits the first one, and that gives him a lead. And so he drops them both. It's a 2-point ball game.
In tense situations at the line, they can count on him to keep this cool.
Here in the fourth quarter, just under 2.5 gone by. Unloads from 13. And that one comes up a bit short.
Listen, simply, when he's got to finish, it's not like the defender was right on top.
General taking things into his own hands.
Just the aggression they're looking for, man.
Well, not just the aggression, the ability to get to the rim.
Huge! Stepping up in the clutch.
It's good. Turner's got 49 in the game.
Oh, what a mid-air adjustment. You know, he had to alter his release point, but didn't let it throw off the shot.
Here's McCollum, and it comes off the front of the rim. The Magic have got almost all of their shots to fall on the fourth. 6 of 7. And another one! And that gives him 51.
Making it look easy. Absolutely ruthless. He's not about to start showing mercy now.
Well, when it's closing time, he's trying to lock the door. He's been going all night.
And the Pelicans call time here. They're behind by 6. There's 48 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And now let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game.
Think about this. He has owned this game from start to finish. Wow. So impressive. The defense literally looked helpless trying to stop him out there. He has been far and away the best player on the court, and it's not close.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Ali LaForce.
Over the last break, I listened to the Pelicans coach address his team. He wants them to up their intensity. He said, quote, relax in too many areas. If we can muster a consistent effort, we have a chance to catch the lead and never look back. Guys, he sounds very confident playing from behind.
Thank you for that, Ali. Turner passes to Carter. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Yeah, he made sure to get
it. So the first one drops, and that puts him at 5. So he gets them both, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Well, you like when a guy calmly steps up, knocks down the free throws, exactly what you want.
6.
26 seconds left in the fourth quarter here. For 3, McCollum. Can't get it to drop. And so they choose to intentionally foul.
Yeah, no choice but to foul in that situation. Although, that's not the guy who blasted into the free throw line.
First free throw is good. And that makes it a 7-point lead. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line. And it's an 8-point ball game. And it looks like they just won't have enough left here at the end.
Yeah, they simply ran out of time and energy.
Ram for 3.
Oh, that's a 3-to-4. They are unconscious from outside. And so far, the defense has had no answer.
Well, that's the whole point, isn't it? If you space the floor well enough, it's almost impossible for the defense to account for everyone.
And no good, as the first free throw misses. We'll see if he can hit the second. That's good. Going 1 of 2 from the line. And that increases the lead to 6. And here's Ingram outside. The shot off that time. And the Orlando Magic have done it. They are the NBA champions.
And all you can say is congratulations. They have done it. A lot of relief right now. The emotions swelling up from all the weight being lifted and winning it all. Wow.
An incredible display of resilience. Seemingly every time they were challenged, Grant, they rose to the occasion.
NBA, I have to give props to the front office for making all the right moves. And the coaching, just phenomenal. And then, hey, it's a players' league. Those guys came out and took care of business.
And thanks to everyone out there who's been with us through this entire journey. Take care, and we'll see you next season.
All right, let's take some questions.
So what does it feel like to own the Bill Russell Finals MVP trophy?
Feel good, John.
I'm so excited I could barely get MVP out.
Hey, man, that'll do it to you. John, it just don't feel like it belonged to me, man. You know, this is something we all work for, so I just want to make sure the fans have a chance to enjoy it, too. Look, several guys on this team could have been MVP. I'm honored they chose me, and it's just something the fans can take pride in for many, 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 many years to come.
Two very important questions here. One, where is the trophy going to go in the house? And two, what is the first thing you're going to do this offseason?
It's beautiful, ain't it, John? It's going to look real good on my mantle. This is it. This is the tangible results of a lifetime of dedication. And it's rare that you get to see all your work sacrificed and crystallized into a brilliant golden ball. But that's one of the advantages of playing basketball for a living. This is crazy.
All right, that's going to do it. Thank you, guys.
I got a lot of people asking me what I think about MP not winning the MVP. And my feeling is, of course he didn't. He was never a serious candidate in my eyes. The media just loves talking about him because he's a celebrity. He brings in viewers. I mean, he's good. He's okay. Don't get me wrong, but he's not that good. He's no MVP. We need to pump the brakes on this kid until he does a lot more in this league. That's how I see it anyway. Carry on. Congratulations to the man of the hour, MP, taking home the Rookie of the Year award. I mean, what can I say? I was wrong about the kid. I'm man enough to admit it. Do I like everything he did this year? Definitely not. But he proved he's a legit NBA contributor, and I can't be mad at that. Now he just got to do it again. Ain't no rookie going forward, just a regular dude. Let's see if he's up to the challenge. Hey, when I'm wrong, I'm wrong. And I was wrong about MP. What can I say? He's got what it takes. He helped his team win a chip. Respect, for real. All that being said, we need to pump the brakes on all that legend talk. How many rings does MJ have? Kareem, Tim Duncan, LeBron, Shaq. MP is a special talent, but is he that nice? That remains to be seen.